focus for tent fires. And one of the things we do attend is road traffic collisions. At Whaley Bridge, it is an on-call fire station, so the firefighters here live or work within 5 minutes of the fire station. All carry a pager, and then if there's an incident within the area, our control room will set the pages off and the crews will turn into the fire station. They've got 5 minutes to come into the station, get changed into all their working gear, and then respond on the fire engine. So, we have got a live casualty today in the vehicle, which is Harvey, which is one of our newest recruits, still yet to start his training course, but it'll be a good experience for him. So once the crew's ready, let's pretend they're, normally they'll be driving down the road, but we're not going to fly through the crowd in the fire engine. So once they're ready, Nick. And I'll talk you through what they're doing as they're going through it. So the first thing, once we arrive in the scene, the officer in charge will do an assessment. Go straight away to the casualties, look at the severity of his injuries, and then he'll walk around the whole scene. Looking all around the scene, looking under the vehicles to make sure there's nobody else trapped, and making sure that both vehicles are in a position where we can work on them. He's also, you can see, approached the casualty first, just to see the condition and just to have a look at the inside of the car to make sure there's no other people. He's now going to brief one of the firefighters. This firefighter will be tasked with trauma care. So this firefighter will get into the vehicle and care for the casualty until the ambulance arrives. We do have some trauma care training. It's a bit more than first aid. We do have quite a good amount of kit on the fire engines. So what you've seen then is the OIC, who have given a brief. As the OIC is looking at the incident, it'll be coming up with a plan in his head of what he needs to do and how he's going to do it. What you can see now is the crew using these what look like giant yellow Lego bricks. These are to stabilise the vehicle to put underneath. As you wear, cars all have suspension, and what we don't want is that suspension moving to allow that vehicle to move, which may move the casualty and cause further injuries. So what they'll do is they'll work all the way around the car, put at least 4 points underneath the vehicle, and it creates a stable platform for them to perform their job. You'll see one firefighter leaving it inside the car. What they're doing is putting a special bag over the steering wheel, and this is in case the airbag hasn't deployed. This bag will stop the airbag causing any further damage to the cabin. So what the OIC is doing now is discussing with the person who's going to perform care, discussing the injuries that they've noted already, and they're going to come up with a plan of how to get that person in the vehicle. As you can see, the firefighters have all got their equipment out on the floor ready. This is so that whenever they need something, they can take it straight from there and then put it straight back. That way we know where all the equipment is. Officer in charge is now speaking to the crew, explaining what plan he wants doing. So what the plan is now is the plan is to get that trauma care firefighter inside the vehicle. How they're going to do that is, although you can see there's no windows, I'm going to pretend there are. So they're going to get access to the boot, and the firefighter will climb through the boot into the back of the vehicle, and then give the casualty a full assessment.
Yeah, mate. There's no opening, can't get in.
So as you can see, the boot doesn't just clearly pop open as easy as we like to type it to. So we've tried one method, so now what you can see is the crew setting up the hydraulic equipment. For some of you may know it is the jaws of life, but we're not going to set this up and try and use this equipment to open the boot. So the next thing we're going to do before they open that boot, we're going to what we call manage the glass. So what we're going to do, we're going to smash this glass on purpose, because then the glass goes when we want it to go. If we didn't smash that glass, as soon as that boot opens, the glass will smash itself into the wrong way. So what you can see, these plastic like teardrop shaped things. So these are what we call hard protection. So these are put around the casualty, so just behind them. So whenever we're working, if anything does, any glass or any metal does go towards it, that's protecting them. We've also got a sheet over them, which is like a nice fly screen. Again, that's protecting any bits of glass or anything that may fly in there. And what you'll hear then is you'll hear Jack shouting at the first of the glass. What this is, anything we do with a vehicle, we always shout that we're doing this just to say everybody aware of what we do. So now we've got our trauma care firefighter inside the vehicle. They can stabilise the torch to reassure that they get a full assessment of their injuries ready for when the ambulance gets there. Incident commander's now telling the crew what the next steps are. So his plan will be initially, if the casualty deteriorates, what is the quickest way to get another vehicle? So then, what's the quickest way? Yeah, so rapid extrication routes, if this casualty deteriorates, will be straight out of the boot the way the trauma care will be done. He's then going to decide the best way to do a full extrication. Today is going to be roof removal. So what the crew are going to do is they're going to prepare the vehicle to remove the roof. We were just discussing now what the fire chief's going to do. Thank you. So what you can see on the driver's side is the firefighter uses that metal tool. What they're trying to do is create a gap that's big enough for that high quality bridge to fall back.
Thank you. is to assist with getting them out of the vehicle again smoothly. This allows them to have more control over the casualty while moving out of the vehicle. You may not be able to see from the ground, but there's always a firefighter that's got two hands on the casualty's head at all times, trying to keep him straight in case of any back injuries.
When you're ready,
the person holding the head is also in charge of any movements that's going to be done, which you'll see shortly as they slide up and go on board, to make sure that everybody has hands on and is ready to lift.
Ready,
Yeah, hands on. Now, a couple of extra strikes on, just five passengers down free. Help lift them from front of the vehicle. This allows them to keep the head in the straight position again, to protect them from any back injuries.
Alcohol,
make up.